I know of no family that has greater credibility in the world of college football than the Manning family.
Truly the first family of American football and quarterbacks. The Manning family is one to be held in the highest esteem.
Growing up in high school, Archie Manning was probably the greatest quarterback I'd ever had a chance to really see.
Manning rolling to the right. Manning looks. He throws in the end zone. Touchdown!
There are quarterbacks who win championships and who have probably done a lot more that people don't even really remember them. And yet Archie Manning has this little bit of a luster to him.
Manning is going to keep it. He's on his feet at the 10. 5. Touchdown!
He was just the nicest guy and very humble. And, of course, a good quarterback. People just jumped on that bandwagon. It's called Archie's Army. It was just something unbelievable to see.
Archie Super Manning for the touchdown.
Archie Manning finished his Ole Miss career with two straight top five finishes in the Heisman voting. His son Peyton carried the quarterback gene as well, but charted his own course by choosing to attend Tennessee.
Peyton's whole life's pattern is after his dad. And his dad is a very conscientious, driven human being. That's how Peyton thinks his life should be led, too.
He's had a great influence on me, and it's nice to be able to ask somebody that's done it before. It's even better when that person's your father.
Some play action. Manning up top, left side. Touchdown, Tennessee!
He had complete control of the offensive football team and complete confidence of what we could do with him within our system.
This will be Graham. No, it's Manning on the naked handoff, reverse to the left side. Nobody even knows who's got the ball except Peyton Manning.
The Manning name is almost like a Confederate war hero. You expect to drive into every little town and see a monument of the guy in a traffic circle.
I mean, people in East Tennessee and the state of Tennessee were naming babies after him. Peyton Manning could run for governor in the state of Tennessee and win right now.
He rolls out of the pocket and throws it in the end zone for a touchdown. There's another one for the highlight reel.
Peyton made a name for himself over his 4 years in Knoxville, passing for 89 touchdowns and leading the Vols to a 39-6 record as a starter.
He is mannerly and he is amazingly patient. And my admiration for Peyton Manning was up there, just like it was for Archie. And then Eli Manning came along and obviously they hadn't broken the mold.
Manning sprints right, touchdown!
Like Peyton, Eli made his own decisions. But like Archie, Eli felt Ole Miss suited him best. He set the school passing record with over 10,000 career yards before being selected as the first overall pick in the 2004 NFL draft.
I don't know what would happen if I wanted to go into another school. I don't think, you know, my dad would be allowed in the state of Mississippi anymore.
The biggest thing we could do was to try to recruit Eli Manning, and that proved to be a great thing for us. As fifth-year seniors, won 10 games and won the Cotton Bowl and did some things that hadn't been done at Ole Miss in 30 years.
Manning to the end zone. Touchdown.
Archie Manning put Ole Miss football on the map, and he's been a good representation of Ole Miss. And to have his two sons to do as well as they've done in the NFL and in college, I just think it's very unique.
People still know who our father was, and you know, kind of figured we'd, you know, be good athletes or expected great things from us, where we just kind of got used to it.
Football in the South is special and it's different. My dad had that experience at Ole Miss. I was able to kind of have that at Tennessee, and you know, Eli had that.
My philosophy there was to just let them play, teach them the right values of team play, of sportsmanship, and those type of things, and just enjoy the game.
Come on, did you really expect us to pick one Manning over another? But it is reasonable.